I think the lesson that we all need to frequently relearn, unfortunately, is that if something's too good to be true, it probably is. And that was my... I remember when Lance won his first tour and the sort of subsequent ones, I just thought this was wonderful. You know, it wasn't so much that he was likable, but he seemed like a true story. He'd had dreadful cancer, he'd recovered from it, and he'd won this incredibly tough event. And there were cynics at that time, and I just thought then... But there's just a few voices, probably David Walsh was probably one of them. When I thought, why are people being so negative? Give the guy a break. You know, he's recovered. And so, like many people, I bought into the wonder of the story, because I think that's our nature. And then when it all fell apart, I felt sort of duped and cheated. But mostly I just sort of, like many people, sort of angry with myself for not seeing the truth when, you know, really in a way it was all quite clear. And, you know, David Walsh had laid it out, that no one's performance can suddenly jump to this quality without some sort of artificial assistance. And I think it's like, as I've said to other people, it's like Volkswagen or horse meat or phone hacking or any of these things. It's, we just have to be cynical, which is, you know, it's the unfortunate side of human nature, I think.